Let's have a look at the greedy best first search algorithm. First of all, a simple example. Here we want to go to node 8, that's the goal. And the estimated distance to that goal are 7, 11 and 15 from the three nodes of 2, 9 and 10. So the lowest node, 2, has a distance of 7 as an estimate. So we go through node 2 and that has two children of node 3 and 4. Now node 4 has the lowest estimated distance to the goal. So we go through node 4 and here there's three children, 5, 6 and 7. And the one with the lowest estimate, node 5, has an estimate of 1. So we go through that and we reach our goal. So that had a path to go from 1 to 2 to 4 to 5 to 8. Now, that might seem similar to the uniform cost search, but they're not the same. The uniform cost search uses costs. How much does it cost from go to node 1 to 2 or 1 to 9 or 1 to 10? Those are costs. The greedy best first search uses an estimate to the goal, which is called a heuristic. A heuristic is the estimated value of the distance to the goal. So let's see these examples. First of all, you may have seen f of n being used as the cost in uniform cost search in algorithms, whereas in the greedy best first search, then the estimate is written as a heuristic, which is h within in brackets. So if you like, the cost is the distance to n, and the estimate, the heuristic, is the estimated distance from n to the goal. Now let's start comparing the two algorithms with the uniform cost search, which you've seen before visits every node and calculates the shortest total distance from the root node to each node in the tree before we get to our goal. Now you can see we've calculated the shortest values, but we've actually used up quite a lot of cost to do that. In fact, with these costs, the total would be 23 because we visited each node in our tree. So that's good to find the path for future searches. Not so good if we're actually doing it at the time. Let's look at the greedy best first search example. So we know it's informed it uses a heuristic, which is the estimate to the goal. So let's have a look. We go through node 2 has an estimate of 7, node 9 has an estimate of 11, and node 10 has an estimate of 15. So we're going to choose node 2. Now that has children node 3 with an estimate of 5, and node 4 with an estimate of 3. So we're going to go 1, 2, 4. Now we can see node 5 has an estimate of 1, node 6 has an estimate of 2, and node 7 has an estimate of 3. So we're going to go 1, 2, 4, 5, and then to our goal of 8. That's the path that we chose. And you can see here that the total cost of that path is a total cost of 8. We can see the numbers there. So our greedy best first search found a reasonable path to our goal. So in summary, the uniform cost search is great for finding the costs to all of the nodes, and eventually we'll find our goal. But if we just want to find our goal, we want to find a reasonably cheap path, then maybe we would prefer to use the greedy best first search. Let's have a look at an example. Now here we've got a person who's trying to find their friend and they're going through a sports complex. Now there's several routes we can take. We know we're going to start off with the cycling, but there are different ways that we can travel to find our friend. So we can see signs saying how far we are to our destination, but we don't actually know which path we're going to take. So let's have a look at our graph. We have different routes that we can take to our friend. We're starting off at the cycling path. Now we have some costs of travelling from one destination to another, or from one node to another. So we can give these places numbers to mark what node they are in this graph. We can use a uniform cost search to find a path that costs 19. So that's a uniform cost search. We can see the path there. Now, we do have signs saying how far it is to where we're meeting our friend, which is what we would use if we had a map or signposts. So here, which way would we go? Well, the distances we have, you can see in red, are from each location, each node, to where we're meeting our friend. So again, we can use these heuristics, and we can see from our nodes the distances to our goal, and when we use our greedy best first search, we can see we have our path that was the same or similar to the uniform cost search. So it found a good path to take. Let's look at the Python code. When you look online, you will see many variations, and perhaps some look more like the uniform cost search. But here we have our graph. We have our heuristics, our straight line distances. So those are defined. Now we have our greedy best first search. We're going to use a priority queue. We'll just briefly look at the code. You can see we start at 1 and our target is 7. And then when we run the code, you can see we visited 1, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So that is our code for our greedy best first search. Now, what's good about the greedy best first search? Well, it's fast, it's easy to implement. If the heuristic's good, it's sufficient, doesn't really use much memory, and you can change it to different things depending on what problem you're trying to solve. What about the bad? Well, it's not optimal. And what do I mean by that? It might not find the optimal path. Let's see an example. Now, if we change our code to the second example, let's take out the heuristic from before, and now let's add the new one. So our new heuristic with the different distances, when we run it, we can see we visit node 1, node 2, straight through to the target 7. Here we look at our signposts with the distances. And here, once we start to look at the distances, we get the path to our goal from 1 to 2 to 7, which is actually a cost of 25 rather than the optimal cost of 19. So when we look at the greedy best first search, it will find a reasonable path, not necessarily the optimal path. So it's not optimal. It can get stuck in graphs, so it's not complete, and of course it depends on the quality of the heuristic, as all informed searches do. Okay, we'll look at more informed searches, and if you like this video, please make sure you like it. If you want more information about things like Python, then visit outs.academy.